outstanding contribution to education of children and welfare of poor widows, which goes to Mr. Raj Lumba, founder and UK chairman trustee of Srimati Pushpavati Lumba Memorial Trust, London. He is the founder chairman of the Rinku Group of Companies, which imports from India and Far Eastern countries. But most importantly, Mr. Lumba is known for his charitable activities through a trust which has been set up to educate children of poor widows in India. He's also promoting better understanding and good relationship between India and UK through a program of visiting fellowships. He, as you know, is the founder chairman trustee of the Pushpavati Lumba Memorial Trust, which he set up in 1967. And the objective of the trust is to promote welfare and education of poor, orphan children, irrespective of gender, religion, or class. The trust is currently educating over 4,000 children of poor widows nationwide and in all of India's 29 states. A Rotary Paul Harris Fellow, Mr. Raj Lumba, has been highly deserving recipient of a number of awards and honours, noteworthy amongst them being the Asian of the Year Award in 1997, the Pride of India Gold Medal in 1998, the Beacon Prize in 2004, and the Lifetime Achievers Award in 2006 presented by the Government of Punjab. And now, Mr. Raj Lumba is the proud recipient of the Priyadarshini Award for his outstanding contribution to the education of children and welfare of poor widows. I will now request Mr. Raj Lumba to kindly receive this award at the hands of our guest of honor, Sri Kamal Nath. As also, I will request Mr. Kamal Nath to present the scroll which goes with it. Mr. Lumba, many congratulations and thank you very much for all that you are doing for the poor, downtrodden children and widows. I will now request you to say a few words in response to this honor. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Raj Lumba.
Thank you for the introduction. Mr. Chairman, Honorable Minister, my Lord, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I feel humble for the honor bestowed upon me by the Priyadarshini Academy. I'm deeply touched. There is no greater honor than being recognized by my own country and by my own people. The award is precious to me because everything I have done has its origin in the culture and value that India and its people have given me and my family. I shall treasure this moment for the rest of my life. I hail from a family where all was well until at a young age my father died, leaving our entire family without any visible support. My mother, Pushpavati Lumba, widowed at such an early age. She was only 37, could have looked after her own interests, but she did not. Almost everything my father had left was used in educating all the members of my family. She did not simply wish to be a statistic as one of India's 35 million widows, nor did she wish her children amongst three times that number. To her, Dharam did not simply mean a prayer at the temple. She was a devout and religious woman. Dharam meant caring for others. It meant providing fulfillment for her children. It meant providing education which would eradicate the cycle of social deprivation that widowed family suffered. She was adamant that she would break the shackles of social exclusion and ensure that her children were educated and would grow up in a healthy environment. It was a practical example of strength and value of her beliefs, which she often described as dharma. This is a lesson that has shaped my life. It has stood the test of time. Today, the charity which I set up in her memory, the Lumba Trust, educates over 4,000 children in all 29 states of India, including 500 children who lost their fathers or parents in the tsunami in 2004. There cannot be a better tribute to my mother than to follow in her footsteps. Education, which Mr. Rupani also said, education is foremost thing. Education of children of widowed mothers must remain the foundation of my charity. That is my paramount aim. In this, I am assisted by Sherry Blair QC, our Prime Minister's wife, and Lord Delakia, one of our trustees, who is here today. So why education? Look at world politics today. Terrorism has replaced Cold War. Tolerance has been cast aside in favor of fundamentalism. The world is divided into rich and poor. Poverty has engulfed millions across the world. Our environment is threatened with global warming. The security of ordinary citizens is threatened, and no nation is immune. War may resolve short-term grievances, but it does not offer long-term solutions. So what is the solution? There must be a way out. Education must be the foundation on which we build a decent, healthy world. We can help children distinguish right from wrong. Education can help to break the disadvantage of poverty. It can help break barriers of discrimination. So that is the start I have made. Shortly, I fly to New York. We are celebrating Diwali at the United Nations on 20th of October. It's the first time in the history of the United Nations that India's national festival will be celebrated, and the Lumba Trust is organizing it. And all the funds which we will raise there will be used to educate children of poor widows in this country. I also go to South Africa. We are launching the Lumba Trust in Johannesburg. Richard Branson, who is a big supporter of the trust, will be joining us there. And we will be starting a program of educating children in South Africa. I want to ensure that the United Nations designates the World International Widows Day, which we have designated 23rd of June every year. Also, the curse of HIV and AIDS, which has blighted the lives of so many widows in the third world, is tackled. You know, when I look at the tearful eyes of those children who are benefiting from the charity, I see in them the image of my mother. But sadness has been replaced by the tears of joy and achievement. Together we can fight the stigma attached to widows. Together we can ensure that the world will not forget them. Together we can make the world a better place to live. Let us educate children of poor widows and give their mothers a chance to live a life of dignity. Thank you.